crazy, but we just got up. It is 6:44 now. I don't think I closed out the vlog yesterday. We had dinner at the Grand Californian, which was super nice. The food was really good. Then we just kind of walked around. We went to Downtown Disney, walked around there. Nick found this hat that he really liked, but they're actually out of it. They're saying they're out of it like resort-wide, which kind of sucks, but I had a mug, and then we just walked around, had a churro, all that stuff. So now it is 6:45. We are up because I'm going to have to try to get us some boarding passes for Web Slingers this morning. So hopefully we'll get in. I've heard that if you can't get in for the 7 a.m., the 1 p.m. is actually a lot easier to get into. So we'll see how that goes. Nick's currently in the shower, getting dressed. We're actually walking over to Disneyland. We're not going to park. We're going to save money on parking and just walk over because our hotel's literally across the street. So you guys will get to see that walk. We were looking up videos of like walking, like real-time walks. And there wasn't one from our actual hotel. So I'm going to do one so that I'll probably do like a separate video also. So that other people will have that in the future if they decide they want to walk. We've never actually walked from this hotel or any hotel before. We've always driven and parked and paid for parking and everything. But with the scooter, and right now the tram isn't running from the parking structure to the park, so you have to walk the whole way, and it's pretty far. So it would be harder for Nick to walk it. And even when you do take the tram, when the tram was running from the parking structure, the tram just drops off in Downtown Disney, and then you have to walk to like the Esplanade between Disneyland and California Adventure, and even that's pretty far. I mean, it's not like super far, but it's a good walk if you have a hard time walking. Or if you have like a bad knee, like how Nick does. So we figured this is gonna do something different. We'll try that. I was kind of upset, not like really upset, but Nick had this like genius idea. We were talking about how we both always wanted to stay at one of the Disneyland hotels. There's Paradise Pier, which I've heard is just okay. I don't really care about that one, but the Disneyland Hotel, and then there's the Grand Californian, which is California's version of the Grand Floridian. And I've always wanted to stay at the Grand Floridian. And last night, Nick was like, well, we should just stay here. And I was like, I didn't think you were going to want to pay $500, $600, $700 a night. Like, that's ridiculous. It's crazy for what we're paying for a few nights there. That's almost the cost of a whole trip to Disney World. And it's like a good amount of the cost to, you know, for Disney World. And I was like, well, we could have stayed for one night. And he was like, what we would do is we would drive up super early in the morning, go to the park, stay one night at the Grand Californian, which has direct access into California Adventure, and then the next day go to the next park and then just leave. We got to go to both parks. We only stayed in the hotel one night, and we paid the same amount to stay one night at the Grand Californian as we did to stay here, which, yeah, I mean, that's, you know, we only stayed one night compared for two or three nights, but to get to stay there, that hotel is gorgeous. The rooms look super nice. You know, you can go right downstairs. They have all the restaurants there, the gift shops. Usually there's a monorail. The monorail's not running right now, but usually there's the monorail. And you have direct access right into California Adventure. And it's the most like economical thing. One night compared to, you know, multiple nights, probably not. But I thought it was a genius idea to get to stay there, because I have always wanted to stay there. And I always thought, like, okay, that'll never happen until we have, you know, until we get better paying jobs, or we have to like, save up for it or whatever. I think it's such a good idea. I wanted to like figure out how to cancel this hotel and do that tonight, and like stay this hotel tonight, like last night, because we had already checked in so we didn't have a choice, but then figure out how to cancel tonight and then like check in at the Grand Californian because they had reservations. I looked, but we'd have to like come up with a story or like make something up, and I don't want to do all that, so we'll have to do that next time. So it's 6:50 right now, so I will check back in when it's time for Web Slingers. So I thought I would show you guys this. I still have 90 minutes until it's time to get the Web Slingers morning group back. Lou from WDW Radio is currently live from Disney World. He's currently live from Disney World because Remy's Ratatouille Adventure is opening off because all the messages are coming in. Remy's Ratatouille Adventure is opening in Epcot today in Disney World. So he's live. I'm super excited to see this. I can't wait to ride it. It's super cute. It is a trackless ride like Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway and Phantom Manor in Tokyo. I don't know. But so he's currently live with that. So that's exciting. It is 6:52, so I have still 8 minutes. Super cute.
So as you can see, the vehicles are using the trackless system, much like Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway.
So I just want to show you guys the Disneyland app. So here's what the app looks like. COVID guidelines, Friday, September. We have park reservations for California Adventure for two guests. And then down here, it shows Avengers Campus is now open. And then this is where you join the virtual queues. So request to join a virtual queue for Star Wars Rise of the Resistance or Web Slingers, Spider-Man Adventure at 7 a.m. or 12 p.m. Virtual queues may be available for other select experiences. So we'll do this today for Web Slingers and California Adventure, and then tomorrow for Star Wars Rise of the Resistance. It's actually 12 p.m. Okay, I thought the second launch was 1 p.m. So you have two chances to get a boarding group, 7 a.m. and 12. I thought it was 1, so I'm glad I looked at that, because I've heard the second time is actually easier to get. Our hotel right now, and obviously it's everybody who's going to the park today trying to get these, but I think today might be a little bit slower. Like, everybody's coming in today because our hotel is empty. This parking lot is really small, and usually it's hard to get a parking spot. And yesterday our parking lot was like empty, so I'm hoping it might be a little bit easier because we got here kind of before the weekend rush. This is get more with Disney with the Premier Visa. I have the Visa card, so I might have to look at it. The hours are not on here, but they're open today from 8 to 10 p.m. California Adventure, Disneyland is open till 11. Mobile checkout. Book a reservation for Droid Depot. That's where you go and build your droids. Mickey's Mixed Magic Fireworks. We saved that tonight. We saw that once a couple years ago when we came with Stations on a trip. And it was really good. I really liked it. Magic Key is the new annual pass holder. Annual passes. Genie service coming soon. So the DAS pass is going to be changing soon. The Disability Access Pass is going to be changing soon. I'll talk about that more later because we're getting close here. Food merchandise. Downtown Disney District. I'm going to go back up to the queue because we've got 1 minute. A lot of people use like world clocks to like count down the exact time in seconds and know exactly when it's 7, and what if your clock's ahead or behind or whatever. And I didn't do that in Disney World, and I was able to get us Rise of the Resistance boarding groups both times, so I'm not going to do all that. I'm just watching the clock over here on the microwave. When it hits 7, I will go ahead and do it. My clock is a couple minutes behind, but $659. Seven. Whip slingers. Okay, it doesn't look like it's letting me yet. So it says it's still $659 according to them. Join virtual queue. Make sure I have Nick and I, yeah. Okay, there we go. So Web Slinger, Spider-Man Adventure, boarding group 45. So estimated wait time is 220 minutes. Estimated wait time is 220 minutes, so that's about 3 hours. So about 10 o'clock. So we got a pretty early one. So yep, that is Web Slingers. That was pretty easy. We'll do Rise of Resistance tomorrow. And I'm going to go hop in the shower now, and I will check back in when we go to walk over to the parks. Okay guys, so here is the name of our hotel, the sign. Here's our hotel. And Disneyland is right there. It's hard to see. It's a little bit of the fun wheel right there. We're literally across the street. It's super smoggy and gray. And I'm not sure if that's like fog or smoke from the fires. I'm not sure, but so we're gonna walk basically just straight down to Downtown Disney. This is West Street and Cotella Avenue. Lobby of our hotel, front desk, there's another little hotel over here. This area has tons of little hotels. Don't hit the back of my feet. And I always say that Disney should buy some of these smaller hotels. This is the other side to our hotel. Should buy some of these smaller ones like this one and maybe this one over here and turn them into value resorts for Disney, like all their version of, I see it. There's like a pool or something on top of the Westin up here. They should buy some of these and turn them into like the All-Stars in Florida. Because these are always packed and always booked, so why not remodel them, you know, Disney theme them, and get the money themselves. No, we just crossed straight. So straight up overhead over here is the Paradise Pier Hotel that I was talking about earlier. There is a little banner for Disneyland. So here we are. on West and Cotella. Our hotel was right over here, and Disneyland is right there. So Coco's right here. There used to be, oh yeah, this is where that little ice cream place was. There used to be a little, like, old school, like, diner and ice cream parlor right here, and it looks like they tore it down. So you can see, it's hard to see in the video, but right here you can see the top of the Incredicoaster. That's the Paradise Pier Hotel right there. I have a timer going so you can see how long it takes us to walk. It is 8:04, so the park just opened. So the scooter that Nick rented. This is our first time with Nick renting a scooter from a company here, and this one's pretty fast. I was saying that the scooter's fast compared to the ones in Florida.
It's faster than the ones in Florida.
Huh. It's hard because I want to take pictures while we walk, but I also want this video to be accurate and like realistic. I guess technically we're going to walk it again tomorrow too, so... I could probably, actually I'll just do that.
What?
I'm gonna take the video today and then tomorrow I'll take the pictures I wanna take.
Whoa.
They can go around.
Yeah, what?
Go ahead. I don't want to get their kids on the phone. I know we just started walking, but so far these Crocs are super comfortable. At night it looks like all these shoes have lights on them. You can see the Christmas lights. So we'll see that tonight. The park closes at 10 tonight. California Adventure doesn't have fireworks or anything right now. World of Color's not going. So there's the Paradise Pier Hotel and the parking for Downtown Disney. Oh, what I was saying earlier is we're gonna stop and get the disability access pass for Nick. We've never gotten it here in California. We did it in Florida when we went in May, and we did it in 2018 when we went. And It worked really well for us, especially in May. We got on a lot of the rides multiple times. It could also be because of COVID and the wait times are lower, but we want to try it out here, see how it goes. They're changing the disability access pass. Right now you have to go to guest services and answer some questions and talk to them, and they will kind of decide what disability like service is best for you. So we're going to do that. But now with Genie Plus coming, they're going to be changing it, and you'll actually be able to speak to a cast member before your trip, like through video call, and they can actually set it up before you even get here. So that's cool. So there's the Paradise Pier Hotel. I've heard that that one is just okay. Of the three hotels, I've heard that that one has the least like theming, and it's, I believe, the oldest or just hasn't been remodeled lately. You can kind of tell if you look at these, at the three. I mean, I'm sure it's still great because it's still such close proximity. But I think if you're going to pay the money, it's more worth it to pay the extra and stay at the Disneyland Hotel. One of the craziest things about Disneyland is that it's so compact. You know, in Florida, everything's so spread out and so big. Like right now, we're walking down the street, and this is literally the back area of Disneyland where they're loading, and it looks like there's cast members maybe on break or something right here. Like I said, we've never done this walk before, so we're just kind of following everybody else. And there's definitely not a lot of people doing this. I thought there would have been more. I think, yeah, today's Friday? Yeah, today's Friday. So I think maybe people are more coming in tomorrow. Today's Friday, September 3rd, so it's Labor Day weekend. We're thinking people might be coming in more tomorrow. Our hotel, the general manager at our hotel said that the hotel was fully booked for the rest of the weekend. I also think because we're coming down Disneyland Drive, this is Disneyland Drive right here, on the other side, like that leads to the Esplanade, is Harbor. On the other side of Disneyland is Harbor, and that's where a lot of the hotels are. So I think that that side, we've seen a couple videos that look like that side gets a lot busier as far as people walking. We saw a video this guy did, walked from the same hotel and went both ways, and this way was just like this, not too many people. When he went the other way, there was a ton of people, and the entrance line was super long on that side, so we're hoping this way will be quicker. So the Disneyland Hotel is over here. So again, still close proximity. I believe there's usually a monorail that runs to both. The Disneyland Hotel actually connects to Downtown Disney, and then you can get on the monorail from there. Oh, I'm sorry. I think so. I was just kind of following them.
Well, you don't know where they're going. You might want to look it up. Disneyland, Downtown Disney, Theme Park Street.
Where do you see that?
Well, that sign over there. Straight over there.
Theme Park, yeah, this way. Yeah, they were going to walk to where that roundabout was down there. Okay. So right here is the Grand Californian. This is the one I was talking about. Nick's genius idea. kind of see what the other people are doing because I don't really know where we're going. So right now it's been 10 minutes. The guy we watched, it took him about 15 to 17 to get to like downtown Disney, so. So this is downtown Disney we're coming up on. Definitely not as big as Florida. So I think around this corner is we're gonna walk and come into downtown Disney to then go into the Esplanade. You can tell, totally different from your experience in Florida. Florida, you just come out and pop on your bus. Brings you right to the front. Thought we were coming up on the turn into downtown Disney. Because this is downtown Disney right here. Yeah, there's the garage down there. There's a garage down there, so yeah. We still have a little bit to go. Now the only problem is that it's starting to go uphill. So the guy didn't talk about that in his video. Part of this is uphill. So my legs are starting to feel the burn. I think it's at that light up ahead. Okay, so it looks like tomorrow's video is probably going to be more accurate.
You want me to go all the way up there and see?
No. Because we're not really sure where we're going. I pulled up the map here. We were following the other people, kind of, and the signs that say theme parks. But I think those signs may lead to, like, the parking garage.
Those signs might take you to the garages.
I was saying, you know, a lot of people here walk, so you would think that they would have had more signs. Okay, so we were able to get in and get our disability access pass, our next disability access pass. They do it a little bit different here. Here you go to the kiosks around the park. You don't have to go directly to the ride to get the pass. So we already got one for Radiator Springs Racers, and we got our Web Slingers pass, so we're gonna go do those first. Remember those churros right there? Let me make sure the way. Do that too.
What?
Do that too at some point. Cozy Cone Motel, we'll definitely be getting one of these later. Thank you.
Just follow Mater into town to get ready.
Mater! Come and share! Howdy!
Here for the big race, huh? It's gonna be fun!
Hey! Here we go, trying to get it. It's easy! You sneak up on him and boom! Ready? Don't let Frank catch you. Oh!
On this planet.
Hippie!
Welcome to Race Day!
At Radiator Springs!
A champion needs speed
and style.
Luigi, give our friend your best!
Let's go! For you, my friend, only the best. Good enough! Oh, yes! Look! Oh, white old tiles! Now you look like a real race car. Guido, to the starting line.
Okay. It takes more than new tires to win a race. I'm your new crew chief.
I'll tell you what to pitch your horn. Get it into the group. So pay attention. Good crowd.
Today we'll come back over here and get a cozy cone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Exciting encounter with the Guardians of the Galaxy. You are now standing in my private office.
I know.
Where I carefully scrutinize each and every piece that comes to me from different parts of the galaxy.
Bless you, this guy.
Hearing your insistent blathering on a constant loop was big motivation for me to escape.
For those of you who have not been paying attention, the name's Rocket, one of the Guardians of the Galaxy, the smart one. Listen up, he's gonna put you on a gantry lift for your tour. I'm gonna sneak on top of your lift and take us all the way to the big old generator control room. I'm gonna blast that thing and destroy all the control systems, which will open up every cage in this freak show and free my friends. Our buddy Mantis is in the getaway ship waiting for my signal, and then we'll be on our merry way. But this plan won't work unless you help. I don't have clearance. My hands don't scan. Yours do. If you raise your hands, I get the clearance, and the chaos begins. It's a foolproof plan.
So I haven't seen anybody talk about this. Word to the wise. When you get your boarding group, you still have a super long line to wait in. For Rise of Resistance, we just walked right on. We just came from back there. And have now waited it, awaiting this whole line. We've already been in line for about 15, 20 minutes. So what's the point of the boarding group if we still have to wait? Rise isn't like this at all, right? So just walk right in.
Crazy alien juice stuff we have Kim Particles and Star Tech. It all helps us develop really cool stuff like these spider bots, for example. Check it out, they have this really cool self-replicating feature.
Because
it's awesome. Buddy, you can stop doing that now. But anyway, you guys are here today to help us test the web slinger vehicle. Using onboard tech, you will be able to sling webs just like my buddy Spider-Man.
Peter, your presentation is getting away from you.
Yeah, I'm a little bit, Sharon. If you could just initiate the safety protocols, it'd be great.
Anyway,
if you want to sling a web, all you gotta do is sling your arm in the direction you want to shoot a web, and that's it.
Peter, your spider bots are continuing to replicate and are consuming everything in their path.
They seem to be stuck in self-replication mode. If you could just handle that for me, please.
On it. Contacting Mr. Stark.
Don't call Mr. Stark! Don't call Mr. Stark. Sorry, Chap. Could you just call somebody else? Ask them to do it.
Okay. Contacting Spider-Man.
Weird. I'm gonna go find Spider-Man or something because he's around here somewhere. Okay, goodbye.
Spider-Man!
As are locked in that awesome self-replication mode. In spite of what you see, they were created to be robotic helpers that can break down raw material and create all kinds of useful tech. But because they are stuck in self-replication mode, the Spider-Bots are currently consuming everything in sight and multiplying at an alarming rate. If left unchecked, my calculations predict this will lead to the devastation of the entire Avengers campus. But it should be safe until Spider-Man gets here, as long as they don't get into the alien fluid. This is now a bigger problem. Activating threat level protocols.
Hey,
Dr. Duck, I need a scrub bottle.
I'm here to help.
You made it. Great. Threat level is at exponential danger. You might need some help. Perhaps I'll call the Avengers?
Don't worry, everyone. I got this. Okay, everybody. Open house is canceled.
Wise idea.
But I could use some help.
Yes, you could.
Sharon, prep the swinger vehicles.
Already on it.
Everyone head to the swingers and we'll team up to stop the spider bots before they destroy the campus.
It's easy.
Okay, we have a plan. Please move quickly through the doors and down the hall to the Slinger Vehicle Bay. Your open house demo has been upgraded to a high-stakes mission to save Avengers campus.
Thank you.
awesome, dude. I'm so there.
Yes, you are, Crush.
Excellent. So, let's all just be there.
Said something about being ways. Repentance in the light and made a switch. Trials. Poor unfortunate souls in pain, in need. This one longing to be thinner. That one wants to get the girl. And do I help them?
Yes, indeed.
Those poor unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my open eyes, but on the trees, and I help them.
Yes, I do.
I do not suffer the winds of the Caspian Sea.
Yeah.
Okay guys, we are heading out of California Adventure now. I just did Incredicoaster again at night. It was so much fun. It's been a great day in California Adventure. Tomorrow we head to Disneyland. I'm super excited. It's beautiful at night. Now we gotta walk back to the hotel, so we're trying to leave a little bit earlier instead of staying all the way till 10. So that is it from California Adventure for tonight. I will probably see you guys tomorrow morning for Disneyland.